Hey y'all, in this video I'm going to get into a quick demonstration of how to install a font for use in the Vectric software. I am using Aspire 9.5, however this works exactly the same way in Cut2D, VCarve Desktop, VCarve Pro, and Aspire. I've had some questions and I've seen some posts in some of the Facebook groups from people asking how to install a new font in the Vectric software. And the simple answer is that you don't install the font through the Vectric software. You install it through the Windows operating system itself. So I'm going to download a font, install it, and show you how to do that. Now, I have several fonts on my computer already, but I have an idea for a shop sign that I need a bigger, more bold font. So I don't really have anything that'll fit the bill, so I'm going to go look for one. And my go-to place to find a font is this website here, Dafont.com. Now, I'm in no way associated or affiliated with this website. This is just the website I use because they generally have what I'm looking for. If not, I can find something similar. Now, there are several font websites out there. If you know the name of the font you're looking for, just a simple web search for it would usually find a result. But if you don't know what you're looking for, I find this one to be pretty good. Now, I'm just looking for a basic font that is a sans serif font, meaning I don't want the little projections that stick out off of the font. I just want a nice, simple, clean, but bold font. So I'm going to come up here under the basic category and go into the sans serif fonts. And here they're sorting by popularity and by size. I can resize and scale the font within the software, so I generally stick to looking for the medium fonts. And I'll just kind of scroll down here and see if anything catches my eye. And the first thing that does catch my eye is one titled The Bold Font. Okay, that's fine. I think I'll go ahead and get this one. I can go ahead and just click on this, and it'll take me to the page that lists the font and shows me all of the characters. Now we can see they're all uppercase characters. There are no lowercase characters, so doesn't matter if I have shift or caps lock when I type, it's all going to be uppercase. And here are the symbols that are included in the font. So I think I'll go ahead and check into this further. Now up here in this corner, we see 100% free. Dafont.com is just a repository of fonts. They don't necessarily own these fonts. The font is owned by the author, the person who made the font. And he has put it up for 100% free. That means it's free for personal use and for commercial use. Not all of the fonts are that way. Some of them are free for personal use. Some of them require a donation to use them commercially. If there is any such restriction, it'll be mentioned up here, and the font will usually come with a README file that you should check out to find out if it's how to get a commercial license to use the font. This one, however, is 100% free for personal and commercial use. There is a button here to donate to the font's author, should you want to do so, and it's something to consider. And then here we have a download button. So I'll go ahead and I'll click my download button. And I have a folder set up that I'm going to download this file to. If we see down here, it's a zip file. That means it's a compressed folder. It will have to be unzipped or decompressed before we can use it. I'm going to go ahead and save that font to that location. I'll click on this little arrow here in Chrome, and click Show in Folder, and here it is. The zip file is highlighted. I have a little pink extract window right here, the tab that pops up. I click on that and I open up the extraction tools. With the zip file selected, I'll click Extract All. It'll open up this window, asking me where I want to save it. I'll go ahead and save it in a folder with this name in the same folder I downloaded this zip file to. I also have a check mark that to show the extracted file when complete. This means that it's going to open up another Explorer window with the unzipped file in it. Now, if I don't want to save it here, I can click on Browse, navigate to wherever I want to save it, and I'll save it there. But I'm going to go ahead for this demonstration and put it in this folder. So I'll click Extract. It does its thing, and a new folder opens up with this extracted TrueType font file in it. Now I no longer need to worry about this zip file, so I'll go ahead and I'll just close that Explorer window. So now we have the font downloaded to our computer, but there's one more step, and this is the step that a lot of people miss. We now have to install the font. It's just downloaded on our computer. It's not installed anywhere. So I'll select the font, right-click it, and if we look in this menu, right here is Install. Now you can install it for whichever profile you happen to be using on your computer now, or you can install it for all users. That means it'll show up no matter who logs into the particular computer if you have several users. I'll go ahead and do that. I'll just click it here, and Windows does the rest. We see a preview over here. That font is now installed and available for use in Aspire, VCarve, or Cut2D. So I'll minimize that window. I'll come back into Aspire, and now I want to use that text or use that font. So I'll go over here to my Draw Text window, and I'll choose that font. See, it start the title of the name of the font begins with a T, so I'll type the letter T and kind of cruise down until I find it. There it is, the bold font. Select it, and now I'll go up here and enter my text. Then I'll tap Enter to enter two lines. I have that set, and now I have my two lines of text. What I want to do is I want to split these into two separate lines now, resize them for my sign. So with the text selected, I'll right-click, come down here to break text block into lines. Click that, and it deselects them both. But now this line of text is separate from this line of text. So I can select that, bring it up into position about so, select this one, click it again to move into move and transform mode, bring it down to about so. Now I can resize them. Hold down Shift to lock them into the center, and that'll work for that one. Then resize this one, and we're set there. Now I need to get into some kerning to kind of spread these apart. I've got letters running into each other. So I'll come over here to Edit Text Spacing and Curve. Click on that. Select the text line I want to work with. Get up here. I'll hold down Shift and click to spread these apart. Hold down Shift again to spread these apart. And I think that works out just fine. So there's my text. I'm now ready to go ahead and V-carve this into a piece of material, then cut it out. Should it happen that you have some text that you're not really sure about, you don't know which font you want to use, you can very easily select the text, go back over here into the draw text box, and scroll through your different fonts and see what you think. Try to decide based on that. But if I do that and I look at my font list, I have a very, very large list of fonts here. I have a bunch of fonts installed on my computer. So I have found an easier way than going through and searching for fonts one by one. And that's another website I'm going to introduce you to with a little bit of a caveat here. And that website is called Wordmark. So I'll go to wordmark.it. I've been here several times before, obviously. And Wordmark IT, some folks will not like this website because it uses Flash. And a lot of people don't like Flash websites. That's understandable. That's fine. I have never personally had a problem with this website, so I feel confident in using it. If you've never used it, depending upon your security settings, when you first come to wordmark.it, you may see a little icon down here that says click to activate Flash. You click on that icon, a window will pop up asking you to allow or block. You'll click allow if you feel comfortable using a Flash website. What this website will do is you type in a word or phrase in this box here, then hit enter. Then Wordmark will search the titles of all the fonts you have installed on your computer and load this word or phrase in all of the fonts you have installed on your computer. So to demonstrate, I'll type in my phrase here. I never finish anything, and hit enter. And now this phrase is being shown to me in every font I have on my computer. So I can scroll down, take a look at that phrase that I want to use for my sign in every font I own. And let's say for purposes of discussion here, I decide that I want to use this font right here, that I prefer that. I just hover my mouse cursor over that font and the name kind of lights up. So now I know that if I want to use this font, I can go to Bernard MT Condensed in Aspire and use that font. It's just a simpler way of deciding which font to use when you have a bunch of fonts on your system, like I do. So that's wordmark.it. I'll put a link to this website and to Dafont.com in the description box down below. So back over here in Aspire, I'm going to go ahead and wrap up this video. Yeah, I know, it's pretty short, especially from me. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, please feel free to leave a comment down below in the comment section. Again, installing fonts for use in any of the Vectric software is all done identically. So I'm going to go ahead and close this video right here. If you'd like to continue to follow me in my CNC adventures or follow along with my Vectric software for the Absolute Beginner series or my 3D modeling for the Absolute Beginner series, please consider subscribing to my channel. Now, I've also had a couple of questions on how to find all of my videos. Is there a main index? And there is. All of these videos are compiled in playlists that are available on my YouTube channel. At the end of almost every video, I put a link up here in this area to this series, the Vectric Software for the Absolute Beginner. And down below, I put another link to another playlist that I think is relevant to the subject. In this video, I'll put V-carving for the Absolute Beginner down here. Off to this side, I put a link to subscribe to my channel. And up here, I put a link to my website where you can go cruise around for more information, check out the t-shirt shop, and maybe pick up a coffee mug or a t-shirt for you or someone you care about. That's at the end of just about every video. So, that's it for this video. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch. And y'all take care.